guys, it's Caitlin. We are here visiting our buddy Jack in Los Angeles, and me and my husband are traveling, so we wanted to just film some stuff while we're here to show you guys some easy things you can do on the road when you don't have much time to get into a gym or if you're dropping in somewhere that you're not used to. While we're traveling, I tend to have really tight hips, and so I didn't want to do the normal lifting. It's really heavy back squats, which is my normal programming this week. So what I'm going to do in order to get some heavy weight lifting in is I'm going to do a 10-minute Emom of two cleans at 80%, but because I want to kind of get my heart rate up, I'm going to have a little fun and throw in four over the bar burpees every single minute with that. So at the end of all of this, I'll do a total of 20 cleans and 40 over the bar facing burpees.
It's a decent amount of work for 10 minutes. And that's exactly what we wanted to show you guys. Like Caitlin said, you don't always have a ton of time when you're traveling. Hopefully you can find a great gym that you can just drop into. A lot of people will do, you know, free weeks or free classes that you can come in and take one. If you got a strict program that you're going by, great, stick to it. Or like Caitlin said, if you have tight hips while you're traveling, which a lot of us have, can have back issues too while you're sitting so much, this is a really great, easy thing to do. And one thing that I love about how Caitlin programmed this here is we've got some hinge dominant movements with a good amount of like posterior chain usage too, with over the bar facing burpees and then cleans. You're getting some like decent glute and low back work in there too, so you can make sure to keep that fortified so you're not losing it while you're sitting in your convertible driving up the California coast. But anyways, we'll jump into it. Caitlin's gonna be running through the movements. I'm gonna coach you guys through it so you can get an idea of exactly how you can do these and make sure that you don't fall to pieces when you're handling a heavy barbell with about 80% of your max clean weight on there.
Yes.
Ready to go?
Yeah.
Let's do it. All right, guys, so one thing that's really important anytime that you exercise, especially when you're using explosive movements or plyometric movements, things like Olympic lifting that are complex and require your central nervous system to fire and the recruitment of a lot of different muscle groups. You've got a lot of things going on here. You make sure that you're not going into it cold. And one thing that's really important that Caitlin does and that I do, and anybody who knows what they're doing when they're doing barbell cleans, especially heavy ones in an EMOM like this, is making sure to go through a nice warm-up. So Caitlin's gonna explain her warm-up progression.
Yeah, so these are some of my favorite progressions of working up to my heavy clean. You're gonna pick up the barbell. Your hands are about shoulder width apart. I'm gonna hook grip, so I'm gonna wrap my thumb under and then the rest of my fingers over my thumb, so I've got a nice lock-in on the bar. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna start off with some power shrugs. So I'm gonna get down in this low position, power position, and I'm just gonna jump up and shrug, get those traps warmed up. Do about three of those. And then I'm also gonna do some high pulls.
And now Caitlin, when you're doing these, how do you go for a certain number of sets and repetitions when you're doing this? Or do you usually do just knock out a couple of each, like going into your full clean?
Well, I've already done a warm-up, so what I'm doing is just kind of like waking up and make sure that those movements are fresh in my mind. A lot of this is muscle memory, and so it's just going through maybe like 2 to 5 reps of each.
That's perfect.
So then next what I'm gonna do is start in my power position again, and I'm just gonna do a basic power shrug, and then I'm gonna go into my power clean. I'm gonna go down to the low hang next. Got your shoulders out over the bar, really using those hamstrings. I'm gonna pull in. Then I'm gonna go from full power. I'm gonna go through this once again, and I'm gonna do a full clean to kind of make sure that I'm good in that squat position. Step back in. Low hang. Full clean. And now what I'm going to do is start adding some weight to the bar and just work up to my 80%.
That's perfect. That's a really good breakdown. I think it's always great to just start with the bar, some light weight on there when you're warming up to a heavy weight, especially when you're doing any kind of Olympic weight lifting like this. I love that Caitlin's doing, you know, 2 to 3 to 5 reps per like segment of the clean, which is really great too. And basically all you're doing, like she said, so we've already done our warm up, we've already done our rows and some ball slams and some hollow rocks to kind of get core warmed up, legs activated, shoulders engaged too. And now we're just kind of refreshing our muscle memory and getting that to engage for the specific movement that we're doing here. It's awesome.
Change.
So I didn't want to do really heavy back squats, which okay. Back up. Clap. Try again.